Today I'm going to review The Picture of Dorian Gray. I really enjoyed the brawl. I know I usually wait till the end to say that, but I highly recommend reading this book if you haven't. It's an easy read. It's not that long. You can go through it pretty quickly. I'll go ahead and talk about the book, but first I want to talk a little bit about Oscar Wilde. So the book feels very British, even though he's born in Dublin, Ireland. So I haven't done a lot of research on him. I don't know if he moved to England or if he just spent his whole life in Ireland, but for whatever reason, it doesn't remind me of an Irish style. It reminds me of a British style. So it's kind of fascinating, but it was originally published in 1890 and it got a lot of criticism when it came out. 6 chapters were removed. I think that Oscar Wilde might have been gay or probably was gay, and he had a lot of gay references in the magazine article, if you will. I don't quite understand. When I researched that, it said it was a magazine article and it's 200 pages and 6 chapters were removed. So yeah, maybe the term magazine doesn't mean then what it does today, but to me that seems like a pretty long magazine article. Anyway, I think that during that time, because of the between the lines gay references that the book has, I think a lot of that was taken out. Probably wasn't acceptable. But I'd love to get a chance to read those. I think it would probably add to the book, but I don't think the book's hurt without it. There is a premise, or like kind of a introduction, if you will, in the beginning of the book, and it's basically an article that tells you how to understand or perceive the book. And also I wanted to just point out that that's in there because when it first came out, really mixed reviews and a lot of people didn't care for it. So he puts that in there to kind of talk about that. And one of the main things that he points out is that a book that's kind of noteworthy or powerful book or a meaningful book, one that comes is written and when it's received, it gets mixed reviews. You know, if some people think it's great and some people think it's bad, and it causes a lot of discussion, basically saying that is what means it's a good. If it was just, it came out and everybody had the same opinion, it kind of takes away from it. So I think it's pretty cool. And I do think I could see how it have mixed reviews, because overall, one of the big themes is morality and is, you know, the difference in right and wrong and societal norms. Really kind of bashing on the wealthy a lot. So probably a lot of people in wealth and power at the time didn't care for all that. Okay, so let's get into the book. Let's talk about the story a little bit. So let's talk about Oscar Wilde's writing style. He uses a lot of imagery, heavy details. I just read Ernest Hemingway's For Whom the Bell Tolls right before this. He doesn't do any of that. It's very minimalist, directly to the point, and so this was refreshing to get every scene, every, you know, place that they're going, every character, every emotion, tons of adjectives, highly going into what we're, you know, what we're seeing, smelling, hearing. It's awesome. I loved it. It's not that long of a book and a lot of stuff happens, yet he's able to give you all this description and it doesn't feel like the story's dragging, so he does it really well. He uses a lot of epigrams, which I think are great. And he also, it's almost like he has all these paradoxes and he's changing things up. So he's like taking things that are cliches and then he puts a little twist on them. And so it feels refreshing, like you've never heard it before. So I'll give you an example. Lord Henry Wotton, which is probably my favorite character, he says to Dorian, "A man cannot be too careful in choosing his enemies." And he would the normal saying is a man cannot be too careful in choosing his friends. That's probably what you would think, but he says enemy, like choosing your enemies. And it's like, that's just one line out of thousands in the book where everything is kind of his own little spin. And so it's fun to read. All of my reviews have basically, I'm going to completely spoil the book and talk about everything that happens. So I guess from here on out, if you don't want to hear any spoilers, just stop watching. Otherwise, I'm going to go ahead and talk about the books. The story begins by introducing the main characters. A painter gives Dorian Gray a photo and Dorian loves it. And basically, we'll just skip a whole bunch. He ends up wishing that the photo would get older and not him. He kind of becomes jealous that the photo is going to be ageless and he's going to continue to get older. And the reason is because basically every single character in the whole book is in love with Dorian Gray and his beauty. And they talk about, you know, he's a man and he's the most beautiful person in the whole story. Everybody that meets him is in love with him, and he starts to really appreciate and like that. So then he becomes jealous of the picture because the picture is done so perfectly, but the picture will be forever at that age, and he knows he's going to get older. And Lord Henry Wotton basically tells him that once he gets older, people won't like him as much. Makes a wish that the picture will get older, and he won't. Now we skip a bunch of stuff. Has an explicit little relationship with a woman, and then something bad happens. I'm not going to get into it. The point is that he comes home, looks at the picture, and realizes that the picture has aged a little bit, and then also it's showing the signs of his sin. So he realizes that his wish came true, he's not going to get older, and the picture is. Now, before he saw this, we kind of get to think about, does he have any remorse for his actions? Well, he did some pretty terrible things to this girl, and she commits suicide, and he doesn't care. Then when he sees the picture and how it had sin and it's kind of taking that, but he never did, he does see a little bit of remorse. But then he kind of continues on. And throughout the story, he's doing kind of horrible things. He hangs out with these high society people, and then he kind of hangs out in the slums. He's doing horrible things in the slums, and then he's kind of not... He's also not necessarily doing good things with the high society people, but we're seeing how the different, you know, like, groups of people kind of bring out the different us and how we act in front of different groups. And then if we feel remorse and the difference between good and evil, we get to see a lot of people wearing masks and how, you know, and it kind of like helped me look on myself and think about the way I act in front of different people. And I thought that was fascinating to read. Let's talk about the characters. There's really not that many. There's Dorian Gray, Lord Henry Wotton, the painter. There's kind of the actress's family with her brother and her mom. Those are kind of minor characters. And then there's like other lords and stuff that are throughout the book. And I love all the characters. There's not that many, but I love them all. I really love the dialogue in the book. And the relationship between Lord Henry Wotton and Dorian Gray is awesome. Lord Henry is basically teaching him all these things. They're basically all horrible things. And it's like he's saying them as if they're fact, but they are his opinions. And they're pretty pessimistic opinions. And so a lot of it influences Dorian, but he does kind of push back against some of it. Characters in the book are fascinating to me. I love, especially... So, what I like about the book is the imagery, the characters, what the feels that you kind of get, the difference between good and evil, morality. I really like the story itself. There's really not a magical component to it other than the whole... It asks us to accept that the picture's getting older and Dorian's not, and then it just uses that to kind of talk about the theme. So I love the book itself. Kind of, it has that 1800 British feel to it, and I think it was really enjoyable to read. What I didn't like about the book. So there is one main chapter. It's like a whole chapter, and it's called The Yellow Book, or I don't know if there's really a title for it, but it's about this book that Lord Henry gives to Dorian, totally influences him, and it's really what makes him kind of start to behave differently. The chapter is just about the book, and the chapter itself is like basically art, and it doesn't really have anything to do with Dorian or Lord Henry. It's just about the Yellow Book. It's really long and it's hard to get through, and I found myself reading it. I'd read a few pages and not even know what I read. I'd have to go back, and I didn't really care for it. I think that if a person gave that chapter the time that it really deserves, because it is so beautifully written, it would be probably one of the highlights. Why can't I say that? It would probably be one of the highlights of the book, but I didn't. I didn't want to read it. I didn't like that chapter. And actually, I tried to read this book once before, and I got to that chapter, and I hated it so much I put it down. It was like years ago, so I don't care for that chapter. I'm probably in the minority, because when I research online, people love that chapter, and I think the book is like a real book. So Oscar Wilde actually took this influential book, put it in his book, gave it to Dorian, and I think some people really like that, but I just didn't care for it. I am going to spoil the ending, so my favorite part about the book is probably when... Okay, so let's talk about the ending real quick. So in the end, Dorian stabs the picture, he feels remorse, he wants to end it, he wants to not be bad anymore. It ends up killing him, he ends up gaining all that sin and age, the picture goes back to what it was. It's an awesome ending. I could talk about it a lot more. I don't really want to get into it, but I feel really good things about it. I put a lot of stuff in my blog about the ending. Go ahead and check that out. It's on stringerstudios.com. I'm going to put a link to it in the video if you want to read about it. I really feel like there's so many cool things about the ending. It was so beautifully done. I don't really want to get into it here. I feel like it's better. I wrote it better, and I like the way I put it there. I don't really want to get into it. But I would recommend it. I'd recommend this book. I definitely am glad that I went back and gave it another chance.